All right, guys, welcome to my garage. So I'm about to assemble my dog's food, and I thought you might want to come along for the ride. So let me just put this beast together, and then we'll talk a little bit more about what I'm assembling. When you're feeding your dog, I think it's really important that your dog gets enough organ meat. How many of you have heard 80-10-10, right? 80% muscle meat, 10% bone, and 10% organs. Hopefully, I can convince you to feed a whole lot more than 10% organs. I'm gonna pop a slide up here. And as you can see, by weight, once you add up all the organs in the animal, including the heart, the liver, the pancreas, the spleen, the brain, the eyeballs, lungs, all of those organs add up to about 25% of the animal. So I'll tell you, if you're only feeding your dog 10% organ meat, it's not enough. Check this out. This shows you the vitamins in organ meats compared to on the right there, you can see just regular muscle meat. And what you'll see is that the organ meats are a lot higher in vitamins than the muscle meat is. Organs are Mother Nature's multivitamins. So if you're only feeding your dog 10% organs, he's only getting less than half of the multivitamins that he needs, and he might be vitamin deficient. The same thing applies to minerals. Check this slide out. Now again, you can see that the mineral content in organs is a lot higher than what you'll find in muscle meat. So again, I think 80-10-10 is not good. It's not enough. If you can source a wide variety of organs, and I'll show you what that looks like in a bit, then you definitely want to get those into your dog. If you can't, then I have a couple of suggestions there to help you out. Because again, you can't skip on the organs because that's where your dog's nutrition is. But first, let's talk about what exactly is an organ. And the funny part is, when you think about what percentage of the diet should be organ meat, you're probably feeding your dog, with the exception of any fruits and vegetables that you might be feeding, you're probably feeding your dog 100% organs. Why is that? Because pretty much everything in the body is an organ. It drives me crazy, these little charts that say, oh, if it secretes, it's an organ. Not true. Muscle is an organ. Bone is an organ. Blood is an organ. Even the microbiome, all the bacteria in your dog's gut, that's an organ. It doesn't have to secrete to be classified as an organ. And I'll explain in a bit why it's important not to limit yourself to think that it's only an organ if it secretes. It's just not the case. So basically, when I say organ, it means any part of the animal that's not fat, that's not muscle, that's not bone, and that's not connective tissue. Pretty much everything you have left is an organ, including the skin. The skin is the largest organ in your dog's body. So I really want you to think about feeding as wide a variety of these organs to your dog as you can, because they all have different compositions and they all do different things. Here's an example. The one thing, let me see if I can find it in my pile here. What do I have here? Whoa, yeah. Okay. This is veal brain. And did you ever go to a Halloween party like on your block and you go through the haunted house and they've got the bowl full of spaghetti or jello and they go, oh, this is brains, put your hand in it. It's pretty much exactly what brain feels like. I'll show you in a bit. It's mushy and it's gross. Why do I feed my dog brains? I do because brains are really, really rich in DHA, which is a really, really important fatty acid that we all try to get out of fish oil. Brain has more DHA in it, that important omega-3 fatty acid that's anti-inflammatory. It has more DHA in it than a lot of fish does. Mackerel especially is rich in DHA, but even then, brain has about half as much as mackerel does. So I love to feed brain. And here's the second reason why you want to feed brain. And this is a really interesting study. A few years ago, Purina released this study where they added DHA to their puppy foods especially. And they said, look, puppies, they did this big research study and they said, puppies are so much more trainable. They're so much more smarter. They can do these mazes and all these things a lot faster when we give them DHA in their diet. So Purina said, look how great we are. We're adding DHA to puppies' diets and we're making them smarter. What nobody thought about was that previous to this study, the diets were actually deficient in DHA and Purina was making puppies stupid because they were feeding them a DHA deficient food. So if you feed your dog brain, which is rich in DHA, it contributes to your dog's brain health. I don't have eyeballs here. I couldn't get them because they had a bacteria thing going on. If you feed your dog eyeballs, they're also rich in DHA, which is good for the eyes. So if you feed your dog eyeballs, it's good for his eyes. If you feed your dog, you've probably given your dog glucosamine sulfate, and hyaluronic acid. Where do you find those? In the joints. What are they good for? The joints. Are you starting to understand what I'm talking about here? It's like homeopathy. With homeopathy, you treat like with like. The same thing happens with organs. If you want a smart dog, feed him brain. If you want him to have healthy eyes, feed him eyes. If you want him to have healthy joints, feed him joints. So for those of you saying, if it's a secreting organ, it's good to go and only sit, you know, and you only need to feed 10%. I object to that. Your dog should be getting kidney, spleen, pancreas, lung. Lung is not a muscle meat. Lung is lung. Muscle is a muscle meat. Heart is not a muscle meat. It's heart. And feeding heart will help your dog's heart. Here's something that's really, really interesting. A few years back, I remember, for the magazine, she wanted to write this article for the magazine warning people, and you probably remember this, there was a big to-do because people were feeding their dogs a lot of chicken necks and they were getting hyperthyroidism. The chicken has the thyroid gland in it, and people who were throwing their dogs a whole lot of chicken necks, the dogs were getting hyperthyroidism. Now what's interesting is that that's really atypical for dogs to get hyperthyroidism. As you probably know, they get hypothyroidism, not enough of that those particular hormones that it fires. So they were all warning, you know, people, oh, don't feed too much, you know, chicken necks. And my thought was, well, wait a minute. If your dog has hypothyroidism, this is good news because instead of giving him those synthetic hormone drugs, what would happen if you just fed him more chicken necks? It's treat like with like. So that's glandular therapy. So apart from the extra vitamins and apart from the extra minerals and apart from the DHA that you'll find in brain and eyeballs, I think it's really, really important to keep your dog's organs healthy and firing well to get as many different organs into your dog as you can. So when I go to, in Canada, we call them abattoirs. You probably call them slaughterhouses. And here's a tip. Where do I get all this stuff? I don't go to the local butcher. I actually have to drive about an hour and a half away to find a place where that's doing this killing and that can sell me these icky parts. And it's worth every second of the drive. Even if you're feeding a commercial diet, like most commercial raw foods only have liver, maybe a little bit of heart. And in my opinion, you need more than that. You need more than that. So, so this is my abattoir, and it's actually at the front of it is, you know, the big public part. I go in the back to the wholesale part where they have the whole pigs and the whole parts. And I go in the back there and get a whole trolley full of stuff. And I'll usually buy about 600 or 800 pounds at a time when I go there. And then I'll bring it all home and I'll show you how I organize it in a bit. So these are some of the things that they have on their shelves. They've got some lots of pig parts, lots of pork. I'm not a fan. Here's some like pig tails there and trotters or pig feet, pig heads. What I don't love about pigs, pork, is the fat. I don't do it anymore. I haven't fed pork to my dogs in years. If I could find pork that was actually, I have my sights now on pastured free-range pork. That I would feed to my dogs. But pork that's raised conventionally, no way, no how is that going into my dogs. And the same with chicken. And usually when you go through the freezers of places like that, that's what you'll predominantly see is pork and chicken, and it's just not for me. And you might have a place like this close to your house. Just snuggle up to some other raw feeders, find out where they're getting the organs from, go on the Yellow Pages, find the slaughterhouses, find the places doing big volumes of meat, and I think you can find these icky bits. Let me grab my scissors and we'll see what's inside of these things. So you saw my brain. Well, not my brain. Some pork calves' brain. This is liver. That's not very fun or entertaining. But I have a thing of liver. Now you'll probably notice there's a lot more liver than there is brain, because what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to build a cow for my dogs. So I know how much raw food I have in my freezer, and this is about 25%. Of all the raw food that I have in there, because I like to feed about, 20-25% organ meat. So I have a lot more liver than I do brain, because the liver on average is about 2% of the animal's body weight, whereas the brain would be less than that. It would probably be more like 1%. So I try to think about how much each of these organs weighs, and I'm going to feed them to my dogs in the roughly the same percentages. So that's my liver, and I'm not going to show you what liver looks like, because we all know liver and we all know what liver looks like. Here, I got me some sweetbreads. So I've got some sweetbreads, which are typically kind of the thymus gland and the pancreas, and those come from calves. So let me get these guys out of here. What do we have in here? I got some beef heart in here. It doesn't look like there's enough. The funny thing about my abattoir is I don't always get what I ask for. Sometimes he tries to pawn a whole bunch of extra stuff on me. Sometimes stuff is missing, and that's super frustrating. You've all seen what heart looks like. There's quite a bit of heart of fat on heart. The beef that I have for my dogs is about 90% lean. It's about where I want to be, so I tend to trim the fat off the heart. I hate grinding heart. It's just a pain in the butt. But there it is. So there's my heart, there's my liver. I have a decent amount of heart there, a little bit more than the heart weighs in the animal, but I do feed my dogs a lot of lamb, and lamb is quite low in taurine, so I just give them a little bit of extra heart in that case. Lung. So I got some lung for my dogs as well. I don't care if it secretes or not. It's lung, it's an organ, and I'm gonna give it to my dogs. Again, I wanna try to assemble a real animal as best I can. What do we got here? Kidney. Kidney is also a pain to grind. Kidney's nice because it comes with another little organ pal, which is the adrenal, which tends to sit on top of the kidney. So that's what kidney looks like. And I got a little bit of kidney. I don't have a lot because I actually bought this special just to show you guys. Usually I have a lot more of this to grind. So this is kind of an easy, what? And this is Christmas. I always ask for veal tails, but it's often hard to get them. This, I have Labradors, so I have large breed dogs. This is my favorite raw meaty bone. I get them to do veal tails for me and to cut them into thirds. I absolutely love these as raw meaty bones. They are just fantastic. I love giving them to my dogs. They love eating them. And that is the best surprise ever. They've just been really hard to get lately. So I'm really, really excited that they had those for me. So we'll put them over there for later. Okay, so my job now is to grind all this crap up together. I'm just gonna throw in little parts from everything, have it all ground up together, and then I'll show you just the rough percentages and how I kinda do my dog food. What happens if you can't get these icky parts where you live? We all say, oh, well, good for you that you can feed whole prey or prey model. You know, I would love it if I could get whole goats, not live ones, and throw them over the fence and have my dogs eat the whole goats. It's just not something that I can do. I would love it if I could, because then I know they'd be getting every gland, every organ, everything they need from that animal. But we all have that opportunity to do that because there's always fish. The great thing about fish is that it's got the skin without the unhealthy fat that normally goes with skin. The main thing about skin is all of these organs and the meats that we feed our dogs are pretty low in vitamin D. And that's a problem because whereas animals that are not carnivores can make their own vitamin D, carnivores like dogs can't. So they rely on the animals that they eat to get their vitamin D. The animals that they eat manufacture vitamin D from the sun. That's just another reason why I don't like feeding my dogs poultry and chicken, because they're raised indoors. They're not exposed to the sun, so they're deficient in vitamin D. Cow skin is a little hard to feed because it's really, really fatty. There are some parts of cow skin where I will give my dogs that, but and even, you know, liver has a little bit of vitamin D in it, as does kidney, but just not enough, nowhere near enough for your dog. So how do you get that vitamin D into your dog? Fish. The great thing about fish is that there's a whole animal, the way he is, with his skin on, his eyeballs, his brains, everything. When you feed your dog that whole fish, and if you feed about an ounce for every pound of raw food that you feed, an ounce of fish, then you're going to do a really good job of getting your dog enough vitamin D. So for those of you who say, I can't get all these organ meats, even those of us who can, it's a really good idea to feed your dog fish to make sure he's getting enough vitamin D. He can't make it on his own. He relies on his food animals. Half of them are raised indoors, and the ones that are raised outdoors, we're not really feeding the skin, and when we do, it's too fatty. So fish is a great choice. And what if you can't get all these organs and you can't get fish? Well, that's ridiculous. I think everyone can get fish. But if all you can get is fish, then I think a really good idea is to give your dog a glandular product. You can get freeze-dried organs, and it's called a glandular. Do it. If you can't get this stuff, then at the very least, get your dog a good multi-gland supplement. Here's my ask. Do not get a glandular that comes from Argentina. It's a lot cheaper. The problem with Argentinian beef is that Argentina is the biggest user of glyphosate or Roundup in the world, and it's just devastating there. I just think you're going to have a lot of trouble with the glyphosate content in Argentinian beef or calf or sheep. So if you're feeding your dog a glandular, please make sure it comes from New Zealand and not from Argentina. Okay, let's get grinding here. All right, so watch out, guys. This is loud. Oh, and don't do this at home. For safety, you're supposed to have your thing on, but I don't do that. So pretend it's on and pretend I'm being safe. All right. So basically, all I'm going to do is I'm just going to pick from one pile. It's nearly not that loud, is it? It's not that bad. I'm going to pick from one pile. Get ready for this. Oh, the brains are just too much. At least I don't have eyeballs to contend with this time. And I'm just going to, you know, pick from one bag and then the other bag and pretty much just keep them all mixed up. Are you going to get in there? Yeah, you're going to get in there. And so on and so forth. Ah, they didn't cut my liver for me. Son of a gun. Little bit of gooey lung. The good thing about the auger is that it actually kind of pulls it through for you. Here's a pro tip. Guys, try to partially freeze your softer organ meats, and they're a lot easier to cut if they're partially frozen. Pancreas. Pancreas is awesome. This is where all of your dog's digestive enzymes can come from. It also controls a lot of the hormones in the body, so dogs tend to run out of enzymes as they age, so adding pancreas to their diet is just a really, really good idea. Woohoo! Whee! This is why I just don't like to, why I wanted to do it at the end of the day, though. Look at how big cow livers are, right? Isn't that crazy? And that's like not even half of it. Some lung. Eyeballs is not one thing that I've been able to get over. I still... Tripe I can do, but eyeballs, I still get really, really grossed out when I pick up eyeballs. It's not my favorite part. Gotta cut this fat off. It's funny, the fat on heart is just so hard. But that's where most of the fat is, or supposed to be in animals, is around the organs, because it's supposed to protect the organs. That's why brain is so fatty. So that's the first batch. Let me just strip this down. So I just kind of rotated all the stuff that I put in there, and it's pretty well mixed up now. It's funny, when we were in Vegas at Super Zoo last year, we went to this Mexican grocery store, and we thought, oh my God, it smells so good. Let's have lunch in there. And we're all thinking, oh, we're going to have, you know, a nice like enchilada or something. But all the locals were eating something that looked a lot like this. And I'm sure it's very healthy, but we had burritos. So what I've done is, this is all frozen. So this is just my muscle meat, and you can see it's frozen, boom. This is my coarse ground muscle meat. And it's just waiting for the nice organs to join it. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my organ meats and I'm just gonna slather them on top there. Again, I want these organ meats to be about 25% of my dog's diet. So I'm gonna fill this up pretty much to the brim. Now you might be thinking, oh Dana, that looks more like that looks like more than 25%. And you would be right. But this isn't the only thing I feed my dog. So if you think about an animal, 25% of them roughly would be organs. But a lot of them would be bone as well. So I need to feed my dog his raw meaty bones. And that's about a quarter of his diet. So I add a good amount of organ meat to their meals. Now, if you haven't done this with your dog before, organ meats can cause loose stools and farting. So just go easy on it at first and just work your way up. Thanks for joining me in my garage and all my organ meats, and we'll talk to you soon, guys.